Alrighty guys, it's Emmet here and welcome back to DevDreamer. So in this lesson then, I want to talk to you about links in HTML. Now, a website without links is pretty pointless, unless of course it's just got information on there and it doesn't need to link anywhere, such as internal pages or even external pages. But for the most part, websites use links in order to navigate around the website and also navigate away to other pages. And in this lesson, I'm going to be teaching you everything you need to know about links in HTML. So let's begin. So the way that we put a link on the page is by using the anchor tag, and the anchor tag is very simply the letter A, like so. Okay, so let's do our opening and closing anchor tags. And so we've got our opening anchor tag here and our closing anchor tag here. Now you notice that with the opening anchor tag, we've also got this href attribute here. Now href stands for hypertext, and then the ref is basically reference. So href is hypertext reference, and this basically lets the browser know where we actually want to go when the user clicks on the link. So let's just say in here, let's just put HTTP, and again, let's just link to Google. Okay, and then here then, in between our anchor tags, we can actually specify what we want the link to be. So let's just say we want the link to be text, which is, let's just say link, like so. Okay, now in the browser, you can see that this is a link. Now if we click on this, it will take us to google.com. So let's click it. And there you go, it's taken us to google.com. Okay, now when it comes to links in HTML, we can either link internally to a page or externally to a page. Let's just open this up again because we linked away from the page. Okay, so we can either link internally or externally. Let's take a look at linking internally then. So in order to link internally, it's pretty much the same thing. All we do is simply specify the name of the file. So if I just move this over a little, you'll see so far then in our HTML lessons folder, we've got the following. We've got this DevDreamer logo, and it's a PNG file, an image. We've got our index.html file, which is the one that we're actually working in. We have our style.css file, where we put our styling. And finally, we have this Toy Story image in here as well that we used from the previous lesson. So we've got these files in there. Now, how do we actually link to those by clicking on this? Well, if we go back to our index.html file, in here, we can actually specify one of these. So let's just go for the first one here. So ddlogo.png. And now if I click on this, it will take me to the image address. So let's click on this, and as you can see, it's taken me then to the actual image address here. So that's how we can actually link to internal files. Let's do another one. Let's link to our CSS file. So that's just style.css. okay, and now if I click on this, it actually links to our style.css and shows what's actually on there. So if you just go to that, you'll see that is exactly what we have in there, image with a width of 300 pixels. Okay, and we can link to other files as well in this way. Okay, so that's how you link internally. Now, what happens if you want to link to another page? Well, it's pretty much the same process. All we need to do is actually create another page in our folder, because we've just got the index.html page, really. So let's go ahead and create another one. So it's Command N for a new file, then Command S to save it, making sure we're saving it in our HTML lessons folder. And let's just call this page2.html. Okay, and hit save. Okay, so this is page2.html. Let's just put some HTML in here, and let's just say page 2. Now, the way that I actually wrote this out very quickly was by using the plugin Emmet, which we spoke about a couple of lessons ago, actually it's quite a few lessons ago now, which basically helps us to write HTML a lot quicker. So we can actually do this. We can just do exclamation mark and then tab, and it fills all this information for us. Okay, so we've got our page 2 here. This is what it looks like here. Very nice, blank page. So let's actually add something in here. Let's just say H1, and let's say welcome to page 2. Okay, and now what we can do is we can actually link to this from our original index.html file. So here then, let's just say we'll keep that at end. In fact, let's change this to page 2. Makes sense. And then in the href here, we can simply specify page2.html. okay, and now if we click on this, it takes us to page 2. We can actually put another link on here to link back to our home page, the index.html. So we can just go back to page 2, and we can just say a tag, and we can say link this back to index.html. And for the text here, we'll just use home. Okay, so now let's actually go back to this and do it from here. So here we can click on page 2, takes us to page 2. We can click on home, takes us back to the index.html file. So page 2, home, page 2, home. Okay, so that is how you actually click through different multiple pages on your actual website. We've taken a look at external files, linking to external files. The next thing I want to take a look at is the different ways in which you can actually link to a page. So you may have noticed that in all our links so far, they're actually opening up in the same tab, in the same window here. But what happens if we want to actually open it in a new tab? Well, this is where the attribute target comes into play. So we can just do space, target, equals, and then our quotation marks. And now you can see we've got four different options. Let's just close this out here. Okay, so we've got four different options. We've got blank, parent, self, and top. Now, there's only going to be, from these four, there's only going to be two that you actually need to know and actually need to learn. The other two, they're pretty archaic and, you know, you really don't need to know them at all. So let's just go through them all. So blank basically opens the link in a new tab or a new page, which is what we wanted. Underscore parent opens the link in the parent frame. Underscore self opens the link in the actual same tab, same window. And this is what it's set as a default, okay? So if you don't include a target attribute here, it will open up as self as the default. And then finally we have underscore top, and that basically opens up the link in the full width of the browser window. Now, parent and top, you're never really going to need to use those. They're the two that we're not going to need to use. The only two you need to concern yourself with are blank and self. Okay, so underscore blank and underscore self. These two, you don't need to worry about them. So let's take a look at underscore blank. We've taken a look at underscore self. It pretty much does the same thing we've seen already. Let's just see it again. So click on here. Page 2 opens up in the actual same tab. But now let's actually open up page 2 in a new tab here. And the way that we do that is we use underscore blank. Like so. Okay. And so now we can actually go here, click on this, click on page 2. And as you can see, it's opened up in a new tab here. Okay. Like so. So that's basically how you link to internal and external sources and how you actually specify how you want them to open. Do you want to open them up in the same tab, or do you want to actually open them up in a new tab or a new window? Okay, so that's basically everything you need to know when it comes to links in HTML. Let me just give you a bit more information about links. You can actually specify other elements as links here. So, you know, if we wanted to, we can actually do, you know, let's just do an image in here. Okay, and let's just throw in this image here. We'll just do Dev Dreamer. We'll be taking a look at images probably in the next video, actually. But okay, we've thrown in our image here. And now this is a link that currently then goes to page 2, because our href is currently set to page 2. Okay, and it's going to open up in a new tab again. So if you click on this, it's opened up another tab that goes to page 2. Okay. The link tag also contains some other cool stuff that we can do. For example, you can actually download this image by clicking on it. And the way that we do that is we simply add the text download to the end of our opening tag here. So let's just clean this up a bit. Let's get rid of this first of all. We don't want that. I'm going to get rid of this because it's fine opening up in the same window. That's fine. And yeah, that's fine as well. Let me just get rid of this for now as well, just to make things a bit more simple. Okay, so we've got an image element here, and then we've wrapped that image element with our anchor tags here in order to turn this into a link. And you see when I hover over it, it comes up with this this little hand icon here, indicating that this is a clickable element. So how then can we actually download this when we click on it? Well, all we need to do is we simply need to state what we want to download in this href here. So let's say we actually want to download this image. So let's go ddlogo.png, okay? And then here, then we can just do space and then download. And then what this will do is when we click on the image, it will actually download the image to our computer. So let's go ahead and try that out. So we go here, we click on it, and as you can see, it's actually downloaded this here onto our computer, okay? Like so. Now, if you didn't want to save it as ddlogo.png, you can actually specify a name here. So we can say download equals, new hyphen name hyphen logo, okay? And then when we click on it again, as you can see, it's saved as new hyphen name hyphen logo. Okay, open that up. There we go. So guys, that's basically everything you need to know when it comes to links in HTML. When we start looking at the HTML5 semantics, we can start looking at things like the navigation. Okay, so we've got the navigation element, which is actually used to store a collection of links. Okay, so in here we can just say href, and I'll just put this hashtag in there just for now. And I'll just say home, let's copy this. Let's make a few more. Let's make four altogether. We'll say home, about, and I'm just going for sort of generic links and buttons you'll see on a website. Contact. And finally, let's just say login. Okay, and as you can see, what that's done is when we've used the nav here, it's actually given us a nice list here of links. And obviously, we can specify where we want these to go and how we want them to actually open up. So there you have it, guys. As I said, we'll be taking a look at the nav element a bit later on down the road. But that's it for now. Hope you enjoyed it. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.